Welcome to MMA Fancast. I'm joined by the recent victorious, just a couple days removed from John De Jesus's Bellator win. John, welcome back to the program.
It's a pleasure to be here, man. What's going on?
It's great to have you as a regular on the show, all the way back to when you were fighting for 247 fighting championships and their 145-pound pro champ. And now that you're in Bellator and just had a huge win Friday, you called it. You said that you, even though the guy had a great record, I think only one or two losses in his pro career, that you were going to hand him a loss in Bellator, and you did. What's it like from your perspective now? How did it all go for you?
I've watched the fight a good dozen times now, and at the time, I didn't know who got it. Now I'm 100% certain I got that fight.
And what made the difference? What are you seeing in the times that you've watched it now that makes you sure that, yes, I definitely got that fight?
Yeah, the amount of times I landed, the amount of times he missed, what he did on the ground, which was absolutely nothing. I got up right away, and just my counter punching in general. I own that fight from top to bottom. He probably got the first. That's about it.
Yeah, and the judges that the two judges it ended up being split decision, but the two judges that had it scored correctly with you winning did give him the first. Still a very dominant win. Let's talk a little bit about, because I looked at the stats, the CompuStrike stats, which I know doesn't really tell the whole fight, but he did land a decent number of leg kicks. First off, were they effective? Were they damaging to you?
Not at all. Okay. They were more annoying than anything else, because if you sparred me, I check kicks, and I don't understand why I let him kick my leg so damn much. But it is what it is.
And then I was going to go to the second point. Always good to know that they weren't really effective to you. They didn't really hurt you. But watching that fight, is that something that stood out to you now that you're able to watch it? I think it was like 27 kicks landed, which I bet in the time you probably didn't even count all of, you're not counting all of them in the fight. So is that something you're going to work on going forward?
For sure. I work on it all the time. Like I said, it was surprising that he landed so many. Won't happen again, though. If you ask anybody who spars me, get one thing on me once. That was his time. That was the one time somebody got leg kicks on me. So won't happen again.
Well, if anything, then continuing to learn from your wins. We always say this, that it's important to learn from your losses. And a lot of people have that slogan, you win or you learn, which is important. But I think it's also great to see your mindset learning from your win. You don't want to just look at a win and say, okay, I was perfect. I was incredible. I don't need to improve on anything. It's always good to stay hungry with it. Given the fact that a lot of his fights from Brazil, and Brazilians are more known for their BJJ grappling, did you expect him, I'm saying this kindly in his defense, but did you expect him to be more dangerous on the ground than he was? Because you've mentioned that the ground really wasn't an issue when you were there.
Jiu-jitsu guys usually need a solidified position for them to get dangerous. I never let him do that. I was constantly moving. I was constantly working to get back on my feet. And that's why he couldn't get any of his any of his jits going.
Well, that makes sense.
His game in general going.
Yeah, no, you stopped his game from getting going. But I was just curious watching it, because there's a mindset for a lot of people that watch fights, understandably so, that BJJ guys are going to be so dominant on the ground. But it's great to see your game plan and your skills paying off, that you know what they would need and you didn't give that to him. So that was really great. Now, you mentioned about the fact that you're hungry, you're always looking to improve yourself. You called out a fighter who, I looked him up, I think he's 17-1. So talk to me, Adam, talk to me about your call out. I think that's exciting. I know it's great for the sport to have call out. So talk to me about your call out. You made it in cage with Big John McCarthy, and then you also have made it since. So talk about this call out, why you're calling out a guy with what looks like a pretty fantastic record.
Oh yeah, he's got a nice shiny record. some DJ out there is impressed or something like that, but I'm not. I called him out because when I first heard about Bellator being interested in signing me or giving me a fight, his name was the name that came up, and I instantly said yes, knowing his name, his pedigree, his what he likes to do, what he's done in Bellator. I knew he was one of the little golden boys, so I was like, hell yeah, I'm down to fight this dude, 100%. It took a few days, and then he ended up choosing somebody else. He said no to me and chose somebody else. He chose an easier fight. So ever since then, it's like I got no hard feelings towards the man. I don't, you know, I'm not mad at him or anything. I just feel like a little bit of an opportunity just slipped through my fingers that day. So I've been wanting to fight him ever since. That's all it is. I want to share the cage with the man, and hopefully he'll oblige.
Well, that makes sense. That would be an incredible fight. It would be really entertaining and a good fight for Bellator to make, because you're proving yourself, obviously, in Bellator now. The two fighters you've beaten both only had one losses. Adam only has one loss, and it's like you are really proving that your skill set is far and above people that have really impressive, like you said, records. You know, just they have shiny records, and there you are showing that you're competing with them and beating guys who are on, you know, 8, 9, 10 win streaks. So pretty great stuff. With your relationship with Bellator, is it something that you kind of wait to see? I don't know. We hear a lot more about UFC, but obviously you're the guy who's hungry. You want to fight all the time. You made a call out, but how open are you to fighting somebody else? Is this kind of whatever you can do to stay busy or active, or would you kind of want to gear towards Adam?
I would love the Adam fight, but I don't care who it is. And you know me. I just want to bang. I just want to bang. I want to get paid. That's all it is. That's my preferred choice. But I'll take on anybody.
I think that makes a lot of sense. And obviously, Bellator is great to have you. I think you're showing just what level of talent you and obviously Kama and all the guys from the academy really are. And it's just beautiful to see you in action. In your dream world, realistically speaking, you thinking fight in September? When would you want to fight again for Bellator?
Yeah, sometime in September, October, sometime around that. I'm healing up some minor stuff from the fight. It was a bit of a war, so I got like little bumps and bruises here and there, but nothing serious. So I'm going to take my week, you know, enjoy time with my family, and then get back to the grind on Sunday.
Well, I'm going to ask you a question because you mentioned bumps and bruises, and I'm sure I already know the answer, but coming from you, I'm sure it'll be better. But you mentioned that you were hitting him and you were hurting your limbs, you know, your feet, knee, fists, you know, because obviously that's what happens in hand-to-hand combat. Obviously, would you prefer to hurt the body parts that you are inflicting damage on them? Or obviously that's got to be better than being hurt by what they're dishing to you, right? If you have to experience pain in a fight, you take it by punishing them, right? As opposed to the other way.
100%. Yeah, I said he was solid and, you know, everything hurts, that whatever I hit him with hurts now. But when you're the one throwing the weapon, when you're the one dishing the pain you get back isn't as bad.
Yeah.
You know, if you don't see a shot coming and you're getting rocked by something, that's a lot worse. So I'll take this pain all day.
Yeah, and well, that makes sense. And I appreciate you explaining it. I think sometimes people watch fighters and think, particularly if all they ever do is punch a heavy bag or something, they sometimes forget that even dishing out pain has some level of pain coming back. So it was just a cool comment you made afterwards. And I thought, you know what? It's a good follow-up, because I think sometimes people watch you and Kama and other fighters that are known for their striking and think, oh, that feels great for them. And it does to win, but it's still a give and take.
Very nice. You're still hitting bone. You're still hitting muscle. No matter how tough your skin and muscles are, you're still going to feel some of that.
Absolutely, you are. So I know you're still working full-time. You're still climbing the trees, cutting the trees and all that stuff. What, if any, what recreational activity, fun, now that the weather in Pittsburgh is glorious right now, what are you what are you kind of looking to enjoy vacation or summer-wise? If you're going to fight in September, October, what are you looking for fun for this summer, looking forward to?
Yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to going to Turks and Caicos, going there sometime in September. And then next year I'm going on a cruise, so we got a couple vacations planned, and we're going to enjoy life, fight, enjoy life some more.
Absolutely, absolutely. Would that be your first cruise?
That would be my first cruise.
Oh, boy. I've been on, I think, 4 or 5, and I've got to tell you, you're going to probably put on weight, because the only thing I did on a cruise, it was great. Now, you're obviously a pro athlete, so you do this anytime, but the first two cruises I was on, after about 4 or 5 days, I couldn't eat as much because I'd eaten so much. So then in number 3, 4, and 5, I would go up to the top deck, get on the elliptical for about an hour to get the metabolism going so I could keep eating. So that's the key on a cruise. Got to work out so you can keep eating, but I'm sure you'll enjoy that. But speaking of summer activities, 247 Fighting Championships has an incredible lineup at Monroeville. Who are you looking forward to see August 7th? And if you're going to the Johnstown card, August 21st, let's talk a little bit about them, because I know there's guys from the Academy going to be on there. So what are you looking forward to in that?
Yeah, for sure. All my Academy guys, I'll be there to support everybody I work with, everybody I don't work with, just the fighters, just local fighting in general. I'll be there, man, and engage in the action. I saw my boy Jake is fighting some dude, and the poster just, the man looks like he's about to eat him alive, and that's the Jake I know. So I'm very pumped for that fight. And anybody else who's fighting, man.
Yeah, when they announced the Jake Schilling fight, they even said, like, this has got a lot of attention. And I know you guys know Jake is an incredible talent. He's coming off a loss, so obviously he's got a lot to kind of get it back going, which is going to be incredible to see him in action. So for anybody in the Pittsburgh area, check out 247 Fighting Championships August 7th card at Monroeville Convention Center. And if you're from the Johnstown area, that Cambria War Memorial Arena, I've heard great things, and it's going to be packed. So check out all the local talent from Johnstown. But thanks again, champ, for coming on. I can't wait. Once you get your fight lined up, we'll have you back on. Thanks a lot, sir. Congratulations again on a great win.
Thank you, man. Thank you. I appreciate you.
Have a good one.
You too.